Glymphatic system, the key to optimal sleep. Sleep, we all need it. It helps us rejuvenate our bodies and feel rested. But ever wonder how it really does this? How can staying relatively still while sleeping at night work wonders for our bodies? It sounds deceptively simple, but the reality is a whole lot of critical functions are super active while we sleep. And they happen primarily when we sleep. In this video, you'll learn all about something called the glymphatic system. It's your body's wonderful way to restore itself and also give your brain the detox it needs to help you feel refreshed and ready to tackle your day. Hi friends, I'm Daniel Arneson, the founder of Activated Potential and the creator of this YouTube channel. Welcome. Here you'll find videos that will help you achieve your highest potential in life. In this video, we will discuss the glymphatic system. But before getting into that, let's review some basics. As you probably know by now, sleep is critical to your health and well-being. If you don't sleep well, you won't feel well. It's truly as simple as that. Bad sleep will disrupt all aspects of your biology, including the health of your mitochondria, which are responsible for your energy. But how can one sleep well? Is it enough to simply sleep for a long time? Many people believe that to be true, but I'm here to tell you that it isn't. In fact, new research is clear. Sleep quality is more important than sleep quantity. And when we sleep, certain systems turn on. One of those systems, and arguably the most important one, is called the glymphatic system. That's what we'll talk about in this video. Point number one, what is the glymphatic system? Before getting into the glymphatic system, let me discuss the lymphatic system, which you may already be familiar with. But if you're not, no worries. The lymphatic system is part of your body's vascular system and serves as a critical role in your immunity system, basically helping to drain out wastes like toxins, certain proteins, and cellular debris. The areas in the human body that have a higher metabolic rate need more lymphatic drainage. So, where there is high metabolic activity, there is high lymphatic activity. Now, let me throw you a curveball. Isn't it surprising then that the brain, which has a tremendously high metabolic rate, completely lacks lymphatic activity? How is the brain able to get rid of all the toxins and waste products it creates when burning energy? It turns out that there is an entirely separate system for the brain, and that's the glymphatic system. We didn't discover this until just recently, but it might be one of the main reasons for our biological need to sleep. The glymphatic system is a macroscopic waste clearance system for our central nervous system. It also facilitates brain-wide distribution of several compounds, including glucose, lipids, growth factors, and amino acids. So it functions in a fashion very similar to the lymphatic system. It clears toxins, proteins, and cellular debris from our brains. It gives us a brain detox, basically. But unlike the lymphatic system, which is constantly running, the glymphatic system isn't active to a meaningful degree when we're awake. It is mostly disengaged then. So when we fall asleep, we activate the glymphatic system, an energy-dependent process. For the body to turn on an energy-dependent system, that system must be very important. Point number two, why the glymphatic system matters. So why does this matter? Why should you care about the glymphatic system? Well, for a good number of reasons, but most importantly, because the glymphatic system clears metabolites and toxins from the brain. It also distributes substances throughout the brain. And because the brain lacks lymphatic activity, we need the glymphatic system to do this. And since the glymphatic system is mainly active during sleep, we need to sleep to clear these toxins that are produced while we're awake. Otherwise, the toxins will simply build up and damage the brain. You definitely don't want that to happen. Not only will the buildup of toxins put you at risk for disease, just like not surprisingly, maybe the lack of sleep does do that. It puts you at an increased risk of disease, but it will also impair your day-to-day cognitive functioning. To understand how critical this is, let's take a look at Alzheimer's disease. The most common symptoms of Alzheimer's disease are difficulty with memory and language. Patients also experience disorientation and mood swings. You might notice that these are all symptoms many of us feel when our sleep is poor, but to a much smaller degree, of course. But for Alzheimer's patients, these symptoms are significantly pronounced. Why? Because Alzheimer's disease is characterized by an accumulation of certain proteins in the brain called beta amyloids. The glymphatic system clears these proteins, so this might demonstrate a correlation between the glymphatic system and neurodegenerative disease. Numerous studies indicate that failure in the glymphatic system might contribute to pathology in neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's. The same holds true in a traumatic brain injury and stroke. For a long time, scientists have been puzzled by traumatic brain injury. More specifically, among those who experience a traumatic brain injury, why do some fully recover quickly while others never recover at all? What causes the difference in neurological damage from person to person? One of the big factors we've identified in those who recover poorly from traumatic brain injury is a higher level of TAU proteins in the brain. As you might guess, the glymphatic system helps clear TAU proteins. A reduction of glymphatic activity might also play a big role in age-related cognitive decline. So to put it simply, the glymphatic system is critical to your cognition, energy, and health, and proper sleep is critical to your glymphatic system. But what if there were more you could do to help your glymphatic system? What if you could optimize glymphatic function and prevent or at least slow down the decline in glymphatic function that happens as we age? Well, this brings us to our next subject. Point number three, how can we activate our glymphatic system? How can we activate our glymphatic system? To answer this question, we need to look at how the glymphatic system functions. I will try to keep this as simple as possible. The brain consists of four fluid compartments: blood, vasculature, intracellular fluid, interstitial fluid, and cerebrospinal fluid. Cerebrospinal fluid, or CSF for short, is what the glymphatic system mainly uses. When the glymphatic system is active, CSF flows from the cortical subarachnoid space into the brain. There it picks up toxins, proteins, and other unwanted materials. Then it exits the brain and drains into the lymphatic system. So we need to ensure proper function in three areas: the glymphatic system, CSF production, and the lymphatic system. For this video, let's focus on the first two. CSF production seems to be mediated by the exchange and transport of ions. This is supported by a 50% reduction in CSF production after administration of the drug ubaine. Now, ubaine mainly works by inhibiting the sodium-potassium ion pump. What this means is that we need the sodium-potassium ion pump to function properly for good CSF production. This might be a cause of concern to some of you, since the medication timolol has also been found to inhibit the sodium-potassium ion pump. Now, timolol can save lives when used to combat heart disease, but it's also often prescribed for migraines. So, if you're prescribed timolol for migraines, we recommend that you talk to your doctor about switching medications if possible. Many other things might impact the function of this ion pump. One of the more interesting is the finding that bound lipids may actually regulate this activity. Polyunsaturated phosphatidylethanolamine, that one is a bit of a mouthful, has been found to be stimulatory to the sodium-potassium ion pump. Additionally, the consumption of animal milk fat, aka butter, has been shown to lead to higher amounts of polyunsaturated, here we go again, phosphatidylethanolamine when compared with the consumption of vegetable oils. As for practical takeaways, I'd recommend that you do two things right away. First, make sure to drink enough water, especially around bedtime. CSF is a fluid and you won't produce the right amounts of it if you're dehydrated. Second, increase your intake of butter and take note of how that impacts your sleep quality. For the glymphatic system to function properly, we need to produce the right amounts of CSF. Not too much either, and of course not too little. So for some of you, increased butter intake might actually lead to worse sleep, but I think that for the majority of you, it will actually be beneficial. Next, let's look at glymphatic activity itself. Interestingly, glymphatic activity does not seem to be regulated by the circadian rhythm. However, we've identified norepinephrine to be a key regulator of glymphatic activity. More norepinephrine means less glymphatic activity. So make sure you do what you can to decrease norepinephrine in the evenings and at night. Now, a number of different factors can impact norepinephrine production. One of the more notable factors is how a low sodium diet can increase norepinephrine production. So make sure to have an adequate intake of sodium, especially in the later hours of the day. Stress is another factor that can increase norepinephrine production. So you really want to pay attention to having stress-free evenings. Other notable influencers of norepinephrine include cold exposure and food intake. The next two big factors we should look at are arterial pulsatility and astroglial water transport. Dysregulation in astroglial water transport has been associated with a decline in glymphatic activity. And arterial pulsatility has been found to be a big driver in glymphatic activity. So we need to take steps to ensure proper astroglial water transport, and we need to do what we can to prevent arterial stiffness. One of the best ways to do this is by making sure to get the right amounts of exercise. Thankfully, all these factors we've talked about can be influenced. We can actually go in and optimize these factors with diet, certain exercises, and supplementation. We can also remove anything that might damage these factors. I know this might all seem a bit complicated, and you might be asking yourself, what the heck can I do to prevent arterial stiffness? Well, don't worry, we will be covering this in future videos. For now, I hope that you've learned something new about this critical system. The glymphatic system is truly amazing, and we can achieve incredible things by optimizing it. Before I end, I'd like to take a quick moment to invite you to visit activatedbody.com to grab your free copy of my Ultimate Energy Crash Course. If you want to improve the quality of your sleep, you probably also want to improve the quality of your overall health and energy. And if you want to detox your brain, you probably also want to detox the rest of your body, right? Well, let my free course help you. Just click the link in the description below this video. I hope you've enjoyed watching this video and that you've learned something new today. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment below. I will personally respond. And if you want to discover other ways to optimize your health, I'd love for you to subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for our new videos coming up every week. Thanks again for your time, and I'll talk to you again soon.